I forgot how to do the mirror set. This thing actually had a thing where it worked like a mirror. Now I have to go the opposite. I can't get the middle of my mustache because of my dyslexia. I'm going the opposite way. I went the wrong way. Oh, I got it. That was such a relief. Look, this is like, I am so disheveled, guys. Look, the good news is I'm able to continue. I've had to use science and, I don't know what the word is, some kind of estimation or speculation of some sort to increase my spending power. But it has become even beyond my meager, humble abilities, whatever they are. I mean, hey, look, you guys out there, you gotta realize something here. This is not a comparative game. Normality is an illusion. You're not normal. That's a compliment. There is no normal. Normal is, well, what is it? I guess it's been proffered before you as the ideal. You must fit a certain cast of, genre. Normality. Maybe you were preserved in Normaldahide. That's what it is. It's like formaldehyde. Forget formaldehyde, man. We got Normaldahide. Normaldahide. What happens is you appear to be normal and you disappear. And what is it, this Espergen syndrome? I don't really, it's like, okay, this is some kind of syndrome. You guys, with medicine, they say that if you can classify it, you got it. They didn't learn the lesson with the Chinese physicians. The Chinese had the greatest physicians on the planet, and yet out came the stuff on the Silk Road to Europe, like the bubonic plague. Well, it sums it up. Astro Boy, back in the hippie era. I don't remember what his name was. I just remember Astro. Astro told me, because he was into astrology. I said, okay, well, I must be, one of those star signs there. He says, I want to tell you, he read me the Riot Act. A little knowledge is dangerous. This is what's happening to the face of the earth right now, guys. This is the 37th consecutive higher than average, warmer than average year since industrialization began to put up the smog cloud. It's like they say the planet got crowded too. It's coming up with 3s of cloud. I've been out there, buddy. I've been out there. I covered 50,000 miles in one summer in the United States alone. The place is empty. It's emptier than MTV. What you gotta realize is, I'm rambling on here. I forgot why I was like what I was. The normaldehyde. Yeah, these guys have been pickled and preserved in normaldehyde. Now, look. I used to view people as ants, It's like some kind of ethnic cleansing filter that we all have in our brains for some reason. our damaged brains, genetically damaged. We arrive damaged goods. Tell yourself the truth and you'll never be disappointed. Well, damaged goods. I looked around, and then one time, there was this lady who fell in love with me, and I didn't know that until like something like 10 years later. I met her again, and I fell in love with her. Of course, she'd lost some weight then. I guess that helps, but. She decided that I was Mr. Wrong after a while, and the engagement was off, and I had a broken heart. But I went out with that broken heart and my half bottle of wine a day, by the way. You guys, if the alcohol gets you, fruit juice. Just keep plenty of fruit juice in the fridge, and you can get beyond Phrygia. So, then I began to realize, I was looking at these people, and guess what? They became important. Now, I was a metro singer, you know, out in the metro. So, I'm using my, now I have this high IQ. I don't think I do, but the guys who tested me say, oh, you're in the upper 5% of all intelligence that ever exists in history. And I said, must be nice. I guess they got my name mixed up with somebody else's. But anyway, and let me tell you something. If that's what brains is, kid, just be happy with what you got. It's no big deal. Apparently, if you become intelligent, you become less able to do practical things than the other people. Well, all I want to do is apply to be a carpet layer. And, you know, you said, well, you're going to be on your knees a lot. I said, well, I wasn't going to tell him I had an injured leg from the Army, an injured knee. That's considered a very bad injury, but see, I got around because I had another leg, and I used my injured leg as a kind of like the way somebody would use a placebo leg. What do you call those things? Like, anyway, yeah. So it's like instead of two legs, I had one and a half legs. I still got around the world twice on that one and a half legs. Then like 50,000 legs under the sea, or give me a leg up. Or how about this? My wife went to the Geological Institute of America, GIA, down there in Carlsbad, California, and it's right next door to Legoland. There's a leg wherever you look. That's like King Arthur got a sword from a can-can girl, the lady of the leg. By the way, that's King Arthur's legend. Is, I think, where they got Hail to the Chief. I forgot the name of the composer. He was like this showbiz guy in 19th century London. One of the president's wives saw the show and figured this was cool. They had this song where the chieftain of the tribes, some of the tribes of Britain, would come in. He'd walk in and they had this intro for him. It went like this. Kidding. It went like this. That's right. It's a 19th century British show. You know, one of the hits. It wasn't Broadway. I think it was Covent Garden out there in London. I got my honky-tonk version of that. Prez might want to try it out sometime. I understand it drives them nuts. Every time they go to an occasion, they got some, you know, like, I got a marine band here. No, this is a blues band. But this marine band plays, you know, Hail to the Chief. And, what was it? President Ford. But he found out he didn't have to do that. So he had his school song played from, I think it's like his high school. Was it high school or college? Was it the high school or the college? I'm asking you, Fritz. Well, I think it was college. Well, let's get in the retardus and time to go into the past. Oh, what planet are you from? I'm not from the planet. I'm from the I'm from the diary.
You're all crazy, and you must go to exterminate!
Oh, Doctor, you must come to Boobaland, because we are needing some assistance here.
Never mind, I gotta get back to my regular scheduled program. I got a lot of people out there that have pickled themselves in Normaldahide. Fame and fortune. Yeah, so, so you think there's such a thing as normal? This is one of my little. I tried doing the blog thing, man. It didn't fit me. I don't know who has those stars. But the fault, dear Brutus, is not in our stars, but in ourselves that we are underlings. A little bit of Shakespeare for ya. Yeah. So, every now and then you see me doing that, I go click. And if when I have a microphone in my ear, you can hear a little click. I'm suffering from the ergonomic problem of these laptops. I would never do this. When I had the desktop, man, I observed the, the Heil Hister concept there. You put your hand straight forward and that's where your monitor is. Now it's down here. That monitor is down so low I expect to find the Merrimack with it. And so, yeah. Dislocations, it's like of the very vulnerable spinal, your spinal system is very vulnerable. So there is no such thing as normality. Everybody is unique, extremely unique. So, whoops, I forgot everything I was talking about. That's one of the problems about being in your 60s. 60 and one coffee. So, we better leave this topic for now. This was only supposed to be a test for a microphone anyway. I wanted to see if my voice would be pick up on the air conditioner. You know, it's like there's air conditioner and then there's hair conditioner. Hey, you know, when you wonder how 64 and I still have my hair color, this is my natural hair color. Oh yeah, there we go. There's some gray there because I'm running out, but you guys want to know about that, that's shale from Utah. But you can do the same thing with sea salt. So what I recommend is, I got honey roasted peanuts here. These are a standard brand from a drugstore, and they're honey roasted, so about what I'm getting out of these, for these peanuts, is I'm getting the oleo acid, an essential oleo acid for my muscles, which I gotta admit, they're depleted now because I've been up here in my little TARDIS doing my homework. And you know how it is with eggheads. They tend to just sit down on their chair. It's like they say charity begins at home. Somebody got it wrong. It's like chair begins at home. So, finish this before I forget. Somebody like a higher brand, like these guys, where you, if you have the money for it, I still got some left. You're going to, they have some that have sea salt on it, and give it about a year. By the way, I would have lost all this hair here. It grew back. Now I can tell you how to do that. It's free. The only problem is it does take your time. So if time is money to you, it is not going to be free, but it is, you don't have to pay for it. You don't have to pay for it because you don't have a toupee. Now what happens is with the male human being is the skin gets tight against the skull and it cuts off the blood circulation. So what you need to do is massage your scalp. The trouble is that people don't massage it correctly. And they don't feel anything, so they figure I'm going bald. And look, it happens to me, even though I know better, I neglected it. But you see, this is new growth here. This is, on this side, is what one thing the barber used to call my barber in, that's what I was going to talk to you about. I remember that. Yeah, I've learned how to extend my buying power, but because things have gotten even worse now, I've had to do without things like barbers. I can only afford really two haircuts a year. That's when I move, so that when I'm on the airplane, people don't think of me as the barbarian of Seville. Now I have to take my glasses off. These are reading glasses I picked up at the drugstore because, well, my wife got them for me. Oh, by the way, guess what? The umbrella is back for those, any of you guys who saw the, little show about the vortex of time. It really wasn't a time tornado. In this case, it was just me putting the umbrella in the back of a shelf somewhere behind a bunch of old bills that we haven't been able to file away because we've been traveling so much, we couldn't have file cabinets. And we couldn't afford a shredder, so we're just mailing our old bills back and forth in ever-expanding boxes. It's the only people who don't have bills are the nobility. I'll bet you they have more than anybody. Oh yeah, so your hair thing, in order to get it to grow back, now listen, it's in not in just massaging your head, it's in the technique. You have to keep working like this to get it to start, and then once you get it started, it's like you're pushing the blood under the scalp down through, and it actually goes down through your face like that. After a while, you begin to feel the nerves have become numb up there, but that you can begin to feel almost like a hungry itch under your skin. See how I'm starting to use pressure on my fingertips? Now, I should have done that every day. This is probably the first day in about 2 weeks I've done that. The best thing is to put your elbows, rest your elbows on something. Like, kneel beside your bed. People will think you've gone religious. And get that blood flowing back in your hair. You have hair today and hair tomorrow, or no hair today, hair tomorrow. Remember, with all this biological level stuff, it takes time. So you're going to have to be repeating this 7 months to a year and a half. So I was going to do this. I got it out of the way. Now, if this microphone didn't work,
I am going to be.
Oh, time to get out of here. Woo! That's how I travel through the wormhole. Woo! Woo! Worked. Well, even though I have clothes on, I'm still bare.
We're back in time now. See? That actually was the behind me on the rock there. That was the statue on Mars, you know. And now it's time for the news. Floods are increasing because, since the Earth is warming, and I'm not saying this out of theory, I'm saying that's the thermometer. The Thermopylae thermometer, buddy. The hotter, warmer air is holding more of that water that got melted in the Arctic Ocean there, which they used to call the Northwest Passage. Well, that's it for today. Remember, 2 days are better than one. Now look, to recap this, let's see now, if I can remember what it was. Nope, got too much blank time there. Maybe I ought to bring a sketch pad out and draw a blank.